Well, tonight, almost two dozen Syracuse University students are suspended after gathering in that large group and violating public health policy. Good evening. I'm Matt Mulcahy.
And I'm Megan Coleman. We heard from neighbors and Central New York leaders who were shocked by what they saw.
These are photos from the gathering on the quad on the campus Wednesday night, taken by an SU professor. He saw it grow from a small group to a large gathering. There was music, dancing, and very few face masks. Tonight, we turn to a behavior analyst to try to understand what compels people to gather and break these social distancing rules. Our Amanda Chin joins us live from Syracuse with that perspective tonight. Amanda?
This behavior expert tells me students at this age crave that social attention, and because they've been missing it could be a big reason as to why this gathering happened in the first place. All of us have been forced to quarantine whether we like it or not.
If you didn't have anything to eat for 2 days and you end up overeating.
Brett DiNovi's been a board certified behavior analyst for over 20 years. He thinks the Syracuse University students probably had instances of accidentally breaking social distancing guidelines over the summer.
Leading up to this point when they went to college, they've been able to kind of get away with little bits of breaking the rules.
Getting inside the students' minds, DiNovi believes people often respond to the most immediate consequence.
They get smiles, they get, like that natural social attention that's been, it's something that we crave as human beings in our DNA for thousands of years.
But that long-term consequence, DiNovi says many don't think about in the moment. And it could be devastating, like an outbreak of COVID-19. The university suspended 23 students so far. DiNovi says many schools may not have another choice but to suspend to prevent it from happening. But for the long term, it can be dangerous.
When people are punished for things, they still have the need for social attention. So they just go places where they can get away with it.
That's why DiNovi believes people respond well to positive reinforcement, rewarding students as opposed to punishing.
When you're always using coercive strategies like a suspension or a reprimand, it makes people kind of want to rebel.
Now, DiNovi also explained it to me this way. Let's say you're on a diet and there's a piece of cake in front of you. You're not thinking about that long-term consequence. You're thinking about how much you want that piece of cake in the moment. Now, he used that explanation to try and compare the students' mindset, what they might have been thinking at this gathering on Wednesday night. Reporting live in Syracuse, I'm Amanda Chin.
Everybody wants that piece of cake, but they do need to understand that their actions can have consequences. Amanda.